Integrating Siri into your SwiftUI project isn't as straightforward as you might expect. You'll need to work with intents, delegate methods. On top of that, configuring permissions and ensuring a smooth user experience can be tricky. But don't worry, this video will break it all down into simple, actionable steps so you can seamlessly add Siri functionality to your Siri. And if you want to meet with me on a one-on-one Zoom call, go ahead and check out the link in the description. So today we are going to take it from the previous episode. It should be somewhere here in the cards and on the end of our video. We have created this app intent. So let me just build and run this so you can take a look at what's actually in there. So this is an email and password, so a text field and a secure field. And let's just go into the shortcuts app. And then I have already created this focus text field. If I run this, I may choose between email and password. Let's just choose email and then click on done. And it will open up the app and focus the email text field. Of course, the keyboard is not popping up right over here because we are in the simulator. You can just do so with command K, whatever. If you are doing this with a real device, it will just pop up. The main thing here is that with that shortcut, with the app intent that was used for the shortcut, we can now focus either the email or the password. Now, what I want to add today is basically a shortcut provider, an app shortcut provider, which will enable Siri to do the same thing. So we are going to have some phrases that will launch Siri. And of course, when you just say whatever we are going to say, you will see in just a second, it will focus either the email or the password. Okay. As an iOS developer, having the right mentor can be the difference between struggling for years and achieving success much faster. That's where my one-on-one mentoring sessions come in. I provide personalized, hands-on coaching tailored to your goals, whether you're a beginner or looking to refine your skills. With years of experience in iOS development and track record of helping developers level up, I help you avoid common pitfalls, master SwiftUI, and accelerate your journey to building high-quality apps. Let's take your iOS development skills to the next level, fast and efficiently. The link is in the description. So, let's just see. Currently, we have an app intent, so that's registered. What we are going to do is just add an app shortcuts provider. Let's create a new file, new empty file. Let's just name this shortcuts provider because then we are going to have conflict. So shortcuts provider, and let's import app intents, and we are going to create this struct called indeed shortcuts provider, and that will be an app shortcuts provider. Where is it? There we go, app shortcuts provider. And then we need to give the app shortcuts. So this will be annotated with app shortcuts builder, and it will be a static var app shortcuts. Yes, it's an array of shortcuts. And let's just add app shortcut. So app shortcut. And we are going to choose the one with intent phrases, short title, and system image. We could just go for the parameter, parameter presentation, but this is more than enough. So let's just choose this one. I did not choose that with the option. So app, shortcut, intent, and option return. So it's just going to go with the intent. Now the intent, as you previously saw, it's our focus text field intent. And then the phrases, we're going to cover the phrases in just a second. Let's just do this in new lines so we can see it a little bit better. Shortcut title, I just call this focus text field. And then for the system image name, I'm just going to grab the pencil and ellipsis rectangle, which I'm definitely going to copy out from my notes over here so I don't have any typos. Okay, so that's the system image that is going to be presented inside the shortcut setup. Okay, so the phrases, this is the fun part. So what we want to do is just add an array of phrases, and we can just have, like, let's say, focus text field in, and then you want to show, want to tell the app that you want to focus the text field in. And for that, we are just going to use dot application name. So whenever I tell Siri focus text field in app intent demo, then it's just going to pop up that shortcut, you know, that app text focus text field intent. We are going to type in email or password, and then it's just going to execute on it. Let's duplicate this, and let's also have, let's just have one more so you can just test it out. Enter credentials in. There we go. So enter credentials in. We need the comma right over here and no comma over there. But you can add basically a bunch of phrases that Siri will recognize for this app shortcut. And that's it. So we now can go into Siri. So I'm not going to test it out, obviously. But after I build and run, it will be available for Siri to be used. And if I just, you know, we are in a Mac environment. If you just ask Siri to focus text field in app intent demo, it will just do the same thing what we actually had in our shortcuts app. This right over here. So it's just going to ask us to enter the focused field which you want to choose. And let's just type in an email again. And then just click on done. And then it's just going to focus email, just like that. Okay, so that's how you kind of trigger Siri, but there's also another good thing that I want to share with you today, and that is a Siri tip kit. It's not Siri tip kit, it's a Siri tip view, sorry. So Siri tip view can be added to your view hierarchy. So let's go to the content view right over here where we had our text field. And right over here, let's just add our Siri tip view. And as you can see, there's one with the intent and one which you can just set it is visible. If you don't choose is visible, then you're just going to have to tap on the X button and it just go away. If you do have is visible, then you can just control its visibility. Now the intent will be our focus text field intent, okay? And is visible, I would prefer, you can just do this on a state variable, but then it would always pop up. I want this to be stored, like the visibility or did we dismiss it or not, inside an app store, app storage. So add app storage, and let's just call this is visible private var is visible, and by default, we should set it to true because, yeah, it is visible by default. And then we can just bind it. $ is visible. Of course, you might want to choose a more descriptive name. Okay, let's just see what's going on right over here. Siri tip you, yes, you want to import underscore app intents underscore Swift UI. So let's click on that. And then it has been imported. So Siri tip view is available right over there. And I find it useful to just also add a padding, right, or just like that. Okay, so now let's build and run and see how the Siri tip view is displayed. There we go. Say focus text field in app intent demo. And as you can see, just grabbing one of my phrases. I believe it's the first one. And if you do nothing, let's say just build and run again, just close the app and do nothing, it will still be displayed. But if I click over here on the X button, it's just going to be dismissing it. But also, because now we are storing this value in app storage, it's no longer going to be showing that Siri tip view. And that's how easy it is to just add Siri integration with app intents into your SwiftUI application. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and check out the link in the description. You can hire me on a one-on-one call. The link is down in the description.